So let's change the text to the icon in this video. I'm going to use the feather icon here. As you can see, they have a very cool and nice icon. You can download them and use them. Of course, you can add all the icons. I'm not going to use all of them, so I will just download the one I need. For example, through the right arrow, I can use this one. I can download it, and if I come to the download here, I will directly open it here, and it will show me the SVG code here. So I will just copy the SVG, and coming to gradient here, to the right, instead of the text here, I'll just paste the SVG here. In the same way for other one, as you can see, one we have for the other direction. So if you come to the application here, we have to bottom, so the arrow should be down. So for the bottom, we will download the down, and again we will open it here, and I just copy it and paste it for this one. And then we have right top, right bottom. Of course, right bottom should be, yeah, this one. And again, I'll come here, copy the SVG, and we will paste it for this one. Instead of the text, we have an icon now. And lastly, we have our app right here. And again, we will copy the code here, paste for the last one. So that way our application will be faster than if you bring all the icons. So I'll just close all of these icons here, and let's see it in our browser. So as you can see, yeah, we have our icons. Instead of, as you can see, instead of these dots here, we can just remove the dot. You can click on them, it is just fine. Okay, I can just change the opacity of this one to 0, that will, it will be fine. So if I come here, we have our radio here. Again, I will go to the style here and say we have inside the Jumbotron, we have input, and the type of the input should be radio, and we have this one, and we should change the opacity to 0. So let's see if it do the trick for us. Oh, still we have them, so we have not selected properly. Maybe we said the input should be and the type of radio, so we should write the type as well here and save this time. If you refresh your page, as you can see, now we have it. If you click on this one, of course this is by default to the down, and everything is working the way we expect, but these are too far, so we should display them side by side. Okay, a little you can do is, let me just close the sidebar here. We have our column here, but you can write the column size as well here. If you write the column size, it will just take that much space it will take. So for this one, I will write column hyphen md hyphen one, and then the medium, it should take 1 out of, let's say, 12, and this one should be also the same, md 1, and for the last two as well, col hyphen md 1. So I'll save it. This time if we open it in the browser, we should see, yeah, now they are closed, and there should be a little spacing between them, so that is easy. We have our direction here. I can just write margin top should be 4, as well as margin bottom must have the 4 value as well. From top and bottom, we must have a little spacing. So as you can see, now we have the space, and everything looks just fine. And this is fine for this video. And next thing is, I don't know which one is active. Yes, when I click on this one, so one of them should become active, and we should change the color of the active one. So that's what we do in the next video.